going to come right out and say it. The Fat General version 2 is probably the best compressor I have ever tried. It is built by Adrian Thorpe and Mr. Dinosaural OTC-201 compressor, the holy grail of compressors. If you can find one, you'll be paying a packet. It's built in Wiltshire in England. Adrian Thorpe, it's an optical compressor. It's an optical parallel compressor. It has two modes. What do you mean by parallel compressor, Burks? Well, if we go to the blend mode and we use the balance knob here, and I'll just put this treble back to noon and the sustain back to noon, what we're doing is we're winding the dry signal from complete counterclockwise through to a mix of both the compressed signal and the unaffected signal. Allow me to show you. First of all, this is an MJT Tele 1960 Robin Ford tribute, I believe. Bought it in a trade. It's a ripper. And I'm running into a straight-up Fender Deluxe Reverb 65 emulation in the axe effect, because it's nice and clean and we're not going to get any microphone compression. All right, turning it on in blend mode, right? That's dry. If I wind it up to noon, it brings in that parallel compression. Wind in a bit more sustain. No tone additives or loss. Just something really nice. No bloom. You want to hear more of that mix? Just the most joyous sound in here, at least, and it feels great. That's, you know, the other great thing that is hard to convey about a compressor is the feel that you get when you're playing the strings. Neck pickup. Something else. Now, if I go to juicy mode, that's the second mode. Juicy mode turns the Fat General into 90% mix of compression and a 10% dry mix, and you basically adjust the overall level here with the balance knob. So if the balance knob is down there, you'll get zero level. You want to turn it up. So there's that kind of country squish, but it's not doing the bloom and the pumping thing, which I hate about a lot of compressors. Then, I'll just put it back into blend mode so I can just wind in my own amount. There's the treble control, which is very subtle, and it allows you to do things. First of all, I'll just play a little phrase, dry. Noon. And all the way. So it's adding that very subtle but oh-so-usable zing. I don't even know why it's got a foot switch, because I don't think I'd ever turn it off once it was on my pedal board. Guitar sounds, you know, almost lifeless without it on. That's great, Brett, but how does it sound with some humbuckers behind it? which is why I've got this PRS Studio here, 2011 Studio. It's got a 5708 in the back, and that pickup sounds like... that. That's actually split coil. Now I'm going to fatten it up even more. No problems with humbuckers. Let's go to the neck. And that treble control is really adding a bit of extra zing to it. We've got a pretty extreme settings. Let's go to juicy mode where the mix is going to be 90%. And I'll up both the sustain, which is the compression, you know, ratio, and the level. So, back pickup. No problems at all. Let's pump it all the way up. And it's so quiet. I love that. One last experiment. You get the idea. This is top quality stuff. Stainless steel, etching, super hard case. It's the toughest pedal I think I've ever come across. Burbrand op-amp chip inside, Neutrik jacks. No compromises at all where quality is concerned. I'm going to turn on a King of Tone emulation in front of the Deluxe Reverb. Slam it with the compressor. Great. Turn that drive off. Get the idea? Let me just go back to this single coil thing here. One last experiment. I just, you know, I can't shut up because it's so good. So that's the coil split between this guy and this guy. This is opening it right up. The Fat General, version 2. Version 2 is smaller and it only runs off the 9-volt DC. As opposed to version 1, which has the same circuit. If you're a compressor fiend and you want to treat yourself, that's the one.